Hello guys, and welcome to my review for the HOTE229 V3. It's a tier 5 German jet, one of the more early ones. And I gotta say, I do like it from what I've seen so far. I think, first off the bat, it's got one of the best designs of any jet in the game so far. No, I mean, who doesn't love a stealth jet? It comes with two 30mm MK103 cannons, with a total of 340 ammo. And what's good about these cannons is, unlike the other German jets, it has actually faster firing ones, because the others, I think, are MK108. So, cannons on this are much better for taking on fighters, and obviously other jets and bombers at this tier. So max speed is 839 km/h, which is not bad at all. Max altitude, 12,000 meters, you know, standard. You never get to that altitude anyway. So that's pretty irrelevant. The turn time on this is 29.3, and when you slow down and use your flaps, you can turn a lot quicker than that. Just have to be careful, because I'll show you in the gameplay, if you go too fast, you can rip your wings. So what else have we got? Yeah, we've got rate of climb, 15.8 stock, which isn't bad again. I mean, it's not as good as some jets, especially the Russian ones. Then again, Russian bias. Totally nothing such as that in the game. The repair car standard is about 8,000 silver lions, which is very cheap for a jet this tier. And that's about it. Oh yeah, it's located at 7.0, as I said, which is very favourable matchmaking for it, because that way you're not facing the stuff like the sabres, which would absolutely wreck you regardless. But yeah, I'm going to show you some gameplay now, and let's get into that. So then guys, here we go, we're into the gameplay. You can see I've got behind the P-80, again an American jet, similar BR. Now, with these cannons, compared with the 50 cals and that, you have to lead quite a bit. Not too much, because these are, like I said, different MK version to the ME262s. Which makes them easy to use, so you can get some good hits. So, I'm following it behind. Watch how I'm not turning too much, because I don't want to rip my wings. See, like turns like this, you rip too much, your wings will break. There we go, one hit with the MK103. Totally killed it. They are very hit and miss, so that's something you've got to watch out for when you use this jet. But most of the time you hit, you'll get a crit, or you'll just blow it up like you saw. So now, I can't see anybody around me, so I'm going towards the AI fighters. Speed it up a bit for you. Now, look here. This is what I mean with the guns. Sometimes you'll fire, and you won't kill. Just got sparks. But then other times, find another one. Here we go. I go up to this IL-2 here, fire a couple of times, and it kills it. It's critted anyway, but he'll go down eventually. Yeah, I always do. But yeah, noticeable. These cannons, they don't one shot. It's rare if they do. Usually just fire a couple towards the target and usually gets the job done. Alright, going up to another one. Yeah, taking a couple of shots. And there we go, he's down. Tail gone. See, you have to be careful when you fly behind these AI. Because one hit has taken out my engine, which is a pain. Because when you lose an engine or it gets damaged in this thing, you have to return back. So I try for this IL-2 here again on my way back, but no luck. No luck. Don't know what quite happened to those cannon shots, but no luck there. So I start heading back, I'm looking behind me to see if anybody's following me. seemed pretty good. Until I get to this point here, I look around and I notice that there's an F-84 on its way. And a lot of the times when you go to land, especially when you play German jets, you'll have an American just come straight at you and kill you. So I originally go to land, I notice the F-84 over there, I slow down so we can land without ripping. Very easily done. And then of course the F-84 is rushing right for me. So I don't start applying the brakes yet. I notice he's still coming for me. So I think about it and then decide to re-accelerate again. Get away from him. I'm watching the F-84, but luckily he decides not to go for me. So then again, I could have maybe landed there and I wouldn't have taken any risk. So we'll speed this up again. Take it around. Big sweep of the wings, landing carefully. Very easily. It's very bouncy when you try to land with this plane the first time, but you can get it. Remy 262 coming into land. Firing off the cannons, good way to slow down in case you didn't know. And we're at a complete stop. Just gotta wait for the repair now. 30 seconds. There we go. We're gonna retake off. Looking around to make sure nobody's following me on the airfield. Keep doing that. Keep doing it, because I guarantee it will save your life so many times. So I'm looking around to see if any fighters are up. Again, nothing. So I go for the IL-2s. Take that one down. Shots are actually being pretty effective this time. Another IL-2 there. Fire a couple. Take off his right wing. Again, looking around me to see if there's fighters. And I notice that in the kill feed you can see an 84 is killing pillboxes. So I look for where they are and sure enough I see a black dot attacking the pillboxes. Now, I come in a little too fast to get this 84. Because for example here, I could have maybe gone in, but if I turned that much, I would have ripped my wing. So don't risk it. Just take up, get your altitude, go to about 600, use your air brake, roll back around, fire again. I get seat, couple of hits there, not much, but I critted its tail. And as we see, he goes down. Easy kill there. So now somebody activates an order. Because there's only two guys left and they're both bombers. So I start to communicate with the ME262 here. And I tell him to go for that B24 there. And I'm going to go look for the other one. I can then see it just on my left as I zoom in. The other, by looks of it, a B-24. Now, you shouldn't rely on your teammates too much, because I let the ME-262 go for that B-24, and unfortunately, he gets taken out. And it doesn't look like he even did any critical damage to the B-24. So now, I see the other B-24. I go in for it. You've got to be very careful with those 50 cals. So here, I come in. I take a pretty risky approach. I take a couple of hits. I get his wing off. I could have left it there, but I carried on. And eventually, there he goes. Taking a bit of right wing damage, but it's alright. You've got a very low profile. So heading on isn't such a bad idea, this thing. Again, taking a shot off the B-24 flying away. Lucky he didn't kill me there. But only hit my engine a tiny bit. and it's damaged the hull slightly, so we're okay. Now, the other B-24 is still a problem, because our ticket bleed, if he stays alive long enough, he can win this. So I know I have to go after him. He's already killed one guy, so I know he's competent. So I do the old-fashioned approach, go underneath it, he's firing the whole time. I'm looking to see where he is. Watching him fire towards me. Now I start to go up. Now I mess it up slightly here because of the roll weight of the wings. And at this point I could have been killed. But I roll up my round. I see his wing. Fire off a couple of shots. Take off the corner. And that's him done. Again taking shots to the fuselage, but we're okay. As you see, that's the B-24 done. And that wraps up the game. So overall, not a bad game, but I chose this clip over the others because you'll find a lot. You either get up tiered, which is very difficult, not as difficult as playing ME-262s to get kills, but still difficult to get kills because you will be outperformed. And there's a lot of F-84 spam at the moment. Those 6M3 50 cal, so they can easily pilot snipe you. But I suggest with this, yeah, you can take armored targets, but I wouldn't recommend it, to be honest. So yeah, that wraps it up. So remember guys, don't take corners too fast in this thing and you should be okay. What else can I say? Yeah, that's about it. Just don't take corners too quick. Try to keep your speed up and fire a couple of bursts onto your target and you should get a couple of hits. Yeah, you might not kill it because of RNG, but if that happens, just go around, hit it again, be fine. So I hope this helped a lot. If you've got any questions for me, you know, feel free to leave it in the comments. Be taking out probably the next German jet, unfortunately, the ME-262 next, but till then, you know, have fun flying.